What's going on, everyone? This is TB2. Welcome you guys back to another exciting episode of the Goldenrod Radio Tower Podcast. But as you do see on the screen, I am not alone. With me is, of course, our co-host, RAVEN89.
Yo, what's going on, people? Another podcast, lots and lots of stuff to talk about. We're going to have a good time tonight.
And even though he doesn't have a webcam, he is the Meowdetch, right? And his Twitter tag is right underneath that. Ladies and gentlemen, he has the music playing in the background. That is his voice. But we're going to introduce you to the real guy. This is Gerard De La Cruz. Gerard, please introduce yourself, buddy.
Hey, what's up, people? TLTPG, you know, we got love. Nothing but love for you guys out there. And then hopefully potential TLTPG heads.
Yeah. So, Gerard, as we always have different guests on the show, we always start off with different questions. So our first question is always, how did you find TLTPG?
Well, that's a good question. It's really easily answered. Not close friend at all. I just met through playing Pokemon, like VGC circuit. Andrew Capuno, also known as Forger, I suppose. Yeah. He was a friend that I met here in Arizona about 2015, around this time. And so I guess I've been in here since Worlds. I've been in the part of the group since literally the World the weekend when you guys were holding your like VGC tourney.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah. Yeah, that was good times. That was good times.
Yeah.
Go ahead and just move.
Oh, right. Yeah, bro. My bad. I forgot what we were doing.
It's all good, brother. It's all good.
Yeah, for the new viewers, we got random battles going on at the same exact time while we talk, so it's a little visual thing that you guys can check out while we're just hanging out, talking about Pokemon, and just talking about, you know, stuff.
Yeah, it's a good idea.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. Now, next question. Now that you've joined TLTPG, and you know, of course, you're a Pokemon fan because you are a part of TLTPG.
That is true.
What is your favorite Pokemon, and what is your favorite Pokemon type?
All right, that is an impossibly difficult question. However, I can answer Pokemon type quite easily. Pokemon type, fire, definitely fire. My favorite Pokemon. It's a real toss-up, but I would actually have to go with Jumpla.
Jumpla.
It's a weird support character, but I do like that. I just like kawaii things, you know what I mean? Like, super cute.
Regular or shiny form, though?
Oh, I mean, obviously I'm a man, so regular.
Please, I would rock that shiny one all day long, okay?
Yeah, that's true. Maybe, I don't know what I was thinking.
I mean, real men wear pink. Let's be honest here.
Yeah.
I would never wear pink.
Oh, dude, I have like three pink shirts in my closet right now. All right.
That's not a bad idea.
Let's see. You got to be. All right, Raven, do you want to go ahead and take the next question?
Yeah, dude. So, how long have you been playing? And what generation did you come in on? And what do you like about Pokemon? Like, what do you like, just the battles, or do you like the story? Like, what really turns you on to Pokemon?
Well, I've been playing since literally since Red and Blue. I'm a Gen 1-er, definitely. I've been playing since I was, 8 years old? I'm 26 now, so, I've been playing Pokemon all my life, basically. I've played every version except for Black 2, White 2. Yeah. And then,
watch me play it and fail.
No, thank you. I'm actually enjoying the series.
Thank you. Much obliged.
Yes. Yes. Oh, dang, Ice Punch to the face. I don't play singles very, very well.
Yeah, but anyway,
as far as VGC is concerned, I started playing like VGC seriously, like when I joined the group, actually. Like, prior to that, like, I went to two events in for VGC 15 and then two events for VGC 14, and, like, I was just sucky. Like, I was terrible. Hmm. And, like, it was not a fun time for me.
But that didn't stop you, did it?
Oh, definitely not. I was like, you know what? It's really interesting how it's a mind game of sorts, but I really was digging the XY art, you know what I mean? When the 3DS came out with Pokemon X and Y, like, my mind was blown and I had to get
blown.
It.
Blown, yeah.
You guys know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, it's like mesmerizing, dude. I fell in love. Like, I already loved Pokemon, but X and Y really, like, everything that I've ever wanted since I was a little kid is pretty much coming through, so. I was just going to ask a question, and I forget what I was going to ask.
How are we living?
Ooh.
Hey, man, okay. That's not cool.
Alright, so basically you're talking about VGC. Obviously, you know, in the beginning you weren't good and stuff like that, and you progress as you go. What did you do to better yourself as a VGC player, and what did you do to basically progress? Like, what kind of tips would you give to someone that is just starting VGC? And for whoever doesn't know, Gerard is actually now qualified to go to Worlds this year, yep. Which I believe he is going. Is that right, Gerard?
Yeah, I am definitely going.
You have at least locked in day one of Worlds, correct? You're shooting for day two?
Yes, if I go to Utah and... this is what I'm looking at. If I get a top cut at Utah on the 28th, I move myself into top 16.
Dang, bro.
Yeah. So, and last year, I believe top 16 gave, like, stipends for Nats and stuff. So that's literally what I'm fighting for right now. I want to make sure I can take me and my lady then to Columbus, Ohio, so I can, like, try and better my positioning for Worlds there. Yeah, otherwise, dude. Yeah. Otherwise, I can't afford it. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
like,
dude.
I got a real job and a real life. Like, Arizona, like, as far as VGC is concerned, we've been really, really spoiled. Like, really spoiled. Like, really spoiled. Like, it's not fair.
Why does like, everything get sucker punch? I swear to God.
Yeah, it's true, but, like, dude, you are wrecking my life right now. Get off me, man.
Don't worry. It's how it goes sometimes, bruh.
Yeah. Oh, you know what? They gave me a scissor without bullet punch. What kind of scissor does
that? See, that's what's so weird about random battles.
Yeah, the random sets. So, what do you do to, what do you do to become a better VGC player? Like, what did you personally do and what worked for you to basically become, you know, qualified to enter a day one invitation to Worlds? Like, how did that go and how did you get to that point?
All right. So, that's a really good question, actually, because when I first started off for VGC 14, I wasted literally the whole season for VGC 14 and the whole, like, most of the VGC 15 season, like, because I'm not knowing basic information, like, when does, you know, the season actually begin? Like, literally the season begins right after, like, a month after World. So, like, if you don't play into that, it could be a bad time, like, as far as trying to collect enough championship points to qualify. So basically that's the first step, knowing, you know, when and where everything starts. And then as far as battling is concerned, I found that as soon as I stopped trying to breed all my Pokemon, like I used to spend so much time just trying to get, you know, 5 IV, there it is, that's the proper 5 IV I need. Like, hell yeah, let's go into battle. Let me put these badass fucking EV spreads here and then try and wreck and then find out that this team of six was a complete waste of time. Like, and like literally my first X version is like maxed out in hours, like playtime hours, because of fucking breeding and wasting EV spread.
Wow.
But basically, the short answer to that question: don't breed so much. Go in and actually fight the fights you're going to actually try and fight, you know, like for live events like VGC. Like, it's cool being good at singles, you know, not trying to hate on the singles community. Please keep fighting those singles battles. It's just that VGC is the official format for Pokemon. So, like, if you actually want to compete with the best, you got to play that format, regardless of whether or not you like it, you know. And a lot of people don't like VGC 16 at this point.
Yeah.
Because of obvious RNG factors being really, really negative, affecting, especially on like roles or like things that you can calculate survive, and then it's just, I mean, that kind of thing has been really prevalent before, but now it's just, since every turn is like could be your possible last turn, it's just really unforgiving.
Go ahead, dude.
That was actually going to lead me into my next question, which you kind of already touched on, was you personally, how do you feel about this VGC 16? Is it 15 year or 16 year? 16?
This is 16 right now.
Yeah, so how do you feel that VGC 16 is, like, in your personal opinion? Do you enjoy it? Did you not enjoy it to begin with? Did you grew to like it? Like, what's your feeling on it? Because I know for me personally, like, while I haven't had a lot of time to really do VGC this year because of school and stuff, me personally, I don't know. I just, like, I'm so wishy-washy with it. I'm 50-50 on the 16 year. So I just want to hear your input on it.
My opinion is, as far as that, I actually like the format. The format really tests whether or not you have like flexibility, because I mean, when you're forced to use, you know, that handful of Pokemon, like it really tests, you know, how far you can stretch your knowledge and your risk taking, risk reward, you know, analysis. A lot of the times it's like plays on top of plays that get you the win, especially in this format. And there's obvious plays that you have to make, but then there's also obvious plays that, like, well, there's also hidden plays, excuse me, that like are really just staring at you in the face that you could just easily make and that you don't, like, anyway,
like running HP water on a Thundurus.
yeah, I mean, you know, there's hidden stuff like that that's really awesome that makes the format fun. Like, I mean, definitely a Smeargle, obviously, has been really amazing. as far as this format, though, is obviously not the most healthiest format, but like I said, I mean, I was pretty much garbage for VGC 14 and 15, so I'm not really, like, the utmost authority on the subject, actually. However, I would like to input that not most of my points, actually, you know, it is correct that most of my CP has come from this format. Prior to the format change, I think I've collected, I believe, like 100 CP before the format change.
Wow.
So that's still a lot. Yeah.
I mean, yeah, I did decent, so it was cool.
I wouldn't call it decent. I mean, you qualified for day one of Worlds!
Yeah, nah, I mean, that's really cool. I mean, I'm not, like, trying to knock it. Like, there's so many people actually hating on the fact that too many people can make it to world easily. And
well,
like,
yeah, that's why, dude, you know, people say, you know, day one of Worlds is nothing now, but day two of Worlds is where it needs to be. I don't think so. Like, I mean, that's still Worlds. That's Pokemon Worlds.
Yeah, that's hours of, you know, practice time and going to PCs and stuff like that. Like, First Day of Worlds is not anything to, you know, snark at. Like, it's really, like, you put time, like, you qualify for the First Day of Worlds, you put time into it. Like, there's no way that you just willy-nilly just got your way there. Like, there's no way. You have to go to PCs, you have to place in PCs to get CP points. Like, it's not like they're handing them out like candy. Like, you have to earn them, so...
Yeah, no, I totally agree, bro. Like I'm on the same, like, chip, but, like, I've had a conversation with, like, you know, other friends in the community, and, like, some other person believes that, like, you know, PCs are literally unnecessary, like, to an extent where they're not really that important. But then, in my opinion, like...
Beg to differ.
Yeah, no, like, I totally agree, like, I have, what, 138 points alone from PCs. Like,
exactly. Because you're allowed to have, what, 6 max for PCs?
Yeah, correct. 180 points max from PCs.
Which, to begin with, even for PCs, with the people that think that about, you know, oh, PCs aren't popular, they're irrelevant. Raven, I sent you a notification, by the way. For the people that say, you know, PCs are irrelevant, it's like, fine, don't go. Let me get in the top spot, and I'll get more CP than you, just because you didn't want to show up.
That is true.
And so, that just never made sense to me, with people saying that.
Yeah, no, it never made sense to me as well, because, like, I don't agree with, like, having to always travel. Like, there's people that can't afford that, to make the travel. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm fortunate enough to, like, have, like, so many PCs in Arizona. Like, it's not even funny. We have a lot of PCs here.
Mm-hmm.
Like pretty much 6 every season, and there's, like, 3 seasons per, like, at least 3 seasons per the whole, you know, unit of seasons. And that means, like, 18 PCs. Like, dude, that's too many. Like, especially when, like, on Twitter, like, I you can find easily people complaining how, like, the nearest PC for them is, like, 5 hours away. Or, like, it just costs money to go to a regional, and then, like, on top of that, the regionals are hard to win. So, like...
Exactly.
You have to be good. Like, so, but it's hard to be good at the regionals if you don't have PCs to be good at, you know what I mean? Like,
mm-hmm.
So I feel like it's for the community, like, as a whole, as far as the VGC scene to grow. Like, the accessibility for championship points has to be there. Like I'm just, like, the outcome of fortunate events, in my opinion. Like, I'm probably not better than anyone else at VGC. However, like, you know, I do put in the time. Like, if you look at my, if you click on my name and check, like, my battle, like, records, it's literally in the 1500s of, like,
I am so sorry about that, Freeze Hacks. By the way, Gerard, if, like, you can hop in and view our battles. That's
yeah. Okay.
Yeah, I just froze his go-go, and I feel so bad.
Oh. Dude, it's nothing but hacks with you, bro.
That's why I don't like playing on Showdown. While Showdown, like, I'm pretty sure, Gerard, you probably team test on Showdown all the time. I just personally hate the hacks that ensues.
Dude, Showdown's dirty, bro.
It's, like, absolutely dirty.
Like, double precipice blades miss in a row. Not cool.
Oh, my God.
But you know what? I don't deal with that anymore. Like, my new strategy for BBC, like, tells me not to ever miss again. Like, that's all I care about, not to miss my moves anymore. And I figured out a way to guarantee that. You guys know, right? You guys know.
Mm-hmm. All right. Tragedy. Raven, do you have any more,
I mean, in regards to VGC, I kind of agree with Brendan in regards to VGC 16, but I kind of agree with you as well with VGC 16. Like, me personally, I'm not a huge fan of VGC 16. I started being competitive with VGC 15, not like I'm a pro or anything, but I started back in 15, and I felt like in VGC 15, there was a lot more allowance with different types of teams that and archetypes that existed. And I feel like with VGC 16, it's a little bit more standard. Like, there's a lot of Big Six that floats around, Ray Ogre's teams that float around. And so in regards to that, like, what do you do when it comes to team building for VGC 16? Like, do you look for, like, do you look for, you know, a Big Six? How can I alter Big Six and make it better? Or do you look for, like, a counter to Big Six and, like, hey, I'm going to run a Ray Ogre with some tricks that can counter? Because, honestly, Big Six is probably the most common team that's out there at this point in time. So what do you kind of look at? Like, do you look at, let's kind of make what's trending better and different, or do you look at, let's hard counter that?
Well, as far as that, like, the analysis goes, what I have to stop. And basically for VGC 16, what I like about it is there are so many hidden gems in this format. I don't know if you guys have messed with Empoleon yet for VGC 16, but that thing is a defensive beast.
Empoleon? Really?
Yeah. So good. Anyway, if this kind of power struggle with VGC 16 where, like, you know, Big Six is dominant, like, it, although essentializing, it's sort of like Formula One, where everyone kind of has the same cars, but then, you know, you fine tune any little thing just to be that much faster. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But basically, as far as team building goes, I mean, like, I've had really good success with every archetype, literally. Like, Ray Ogre's been pretty good. I got top cut with Ray Ogre at Cali Regional with that. I've done Key Ogre Xerneas, and I won a first place PC at the beginning of the year with that. I won a PC with the Pikachu team.
The Pikachu Ray team. Ogre.
Yeah, no, the Pikachu team was really rad. Anyway, seeing that thing Oko, like, Kang and Yveltal, like, is super funny. Anyway, recently I've just been messing with Big Six because I was wondering, like, why people are using it, and, like, there is so many things that Big Six can do, which is why it's really good. And if you can figure out a way to utilize that kind of thinking for team building in this format, or in any format, and really, then you can really dominate, like, the game for, so that you can control, like, the board the way you want it. Because there's a lot of power plays in which, like, just because of having an intimidate in this certain situation, or a fake out, or a redirection in this one situation, can really, really lock up the game for you. Which is why I kind of like it, because then it really, like, tests whether or not you play the format enough to, like, to stop that common team. You know what I mean? And it's always a fucking guessing game whenever you're playing Big Six, because there's so many leads that are really good versus anything that stops Big Six.
Cool, man. Yeah, dude. I mean, basically, you know, that's really cool that you look for the different ways of playing. Like, running a Pikachu on a team to win a PC is pretty ballsy.
That is legitimately one of the coolest things ever. Was it, like, and, was it regular I'm Pikachu, sure, or, like, Pikachu Libre or something like that, or?
It was regular Pikachu. I was gonna run the Bell Pikachu, because Bell Pikachu has a chance to Oko Salamence, but
Ice Shard, right?
Icicle Crash.
Icicle Crash, that's what it was.
Yeah, but then I was like, non-stab, forget it. Like, literally, the moveset for Pikachu was so baller. It was like Balls Out Pikachu.
Yeah, dude.
It was Bolt Tackle, So like two hits, it killed itself. Like it had fake out, faint, and protect. So like it was so beast though. Light ball Pikachu like pretty much one shots Kang.
Really? After that's, like that, that's legit.
Yeah, like yeah, it one shots like most Kyogre. It's like less than like 252 HP or less. Like they're done. Let's see. Even actually, I think it even one shots bulky Kyogre. Like, and it one shots literally anything that's not physically defensive. Like Pikachu. This format is like a hidden gem if you guys know how to use it right.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. Music stop. Let me start replaying that. All right. Do we have any more VGC questions for him, Raven?
Not really. I mean, I can go on for so long talk about VGC because it is the
you're
main
hiding this in
format.
The back, seriously.
It is the main format of Pokemon. So I mean, there's tons of stuff to discuss about VGC, but I don't want to spend the whole thing, the whole cast, talking about it because there's a lot of stuff.
Well, I mean,
something minor that happened today that
yeah,
I can
like
talk about.
Something that, you know, is kind of the reason why we decided to record this Tuesday night at 11 o'clock, or 11 o'clock my time at least, probably 1 o'clock your time, Raven. But, you know, something kind of minor kind of happened that we should really talk about. And that's a freaking Pokemon Sun and Moon, God, starters and legends, oh my god. Oh my god, so
legit. Okay, in case you didn't understand what he just said, they released a trailer for Pokemon Sun and Moon today, so because Brennan had Thumb Brother over here had a little conniption trying to say that.
Okay, legitimately, so I've been sick the past 2 days. I went to bed at 2 a.m. thinking, okay, I can get some sleep, wake up, you know, around 8 o'clock, be ready for the video and stuff. No, my brain didn't want to do that at all. My brain woke me up at 4 o'clock and I stayed up until 6 o'clock until the video went live. I did a reaction to it and I went back to bed. Slept like a baby. But my I was so subconsciously ready for it that, oh my gosh. Like, it was beautiful. It was everything I hoped for, honestly.
I do enjoy full body sprites though. Like those, that was like probably the coolest concept for me. I was like, finally.
Yeah. So, oh my god.
What?
Go Plusle. This Plusle just ate a Dragon Claw. When this thing's what, +3?
Well, you have Reflect up, so.
True, but still. I literally have nothing. You totally win this one. Yep, you totally win. But anyway.
Dude, you almost had me too. You,
I know, I was ready, but you had this thing in the back. There's literally.
Yeah, you gotta play smart, bro.
And you got a crit, of course.
And they crit.
Okay.
Good game.
Alright, Gerard, Raven, you guys face each other now.
Yay.
But okay, so, yeah, let's go to the beginning of what we were saying about. Sun and Moon trailer dropped. It unveiled so many different things. The main thing, of course, is the starters. Can we please talk about the starters, guys?
Alright, just to start off, just kind of disclaimer, I have tons of notes of stuff I want to talk about in regards to this, so we're going to try to get through as much as possible, and I actually have some information that I can probably confirm from analyzing the video over and over and over again, so just a disclaimer, I have a lot of stuff to talk about, but I think the starters is a great starting point to just get some feedback and what you guys think about it.
First off, a lot of people were speculating that the starters were going to be what they were because, you know, the copyrights on, like, that one weird Japanese Twitter copyright or whatever page or something. A lot of people were doing videos on that. But I am not angry with how any of the starters turned out at all. I think it's a perfect balance of something new yet something similar at the same time. Like as far as Rowlet goes, Grass Flying. Something that's, you know, never been done before with grass, I think is absolutely phenomenal. Yeah, sure, catch an Ice Beam, but I don't care. Rowlet is adorable, number one. Litten, It has to be a fire dark type. That I have to personally say right now. We can get into that later, but Litten is hysterical in the fact that its embers are hairballs, and it ignites the oil on its skin. That is what I find hysterical. And then, what was it? Popplio or Lollipop? What was its name?
Popplio.
Popplio, everyone's like, oh, he looks stupid. I was like, I know, I like Popplio. I like Popplio a lot. Like what do you guys...
It looked like a dog got punched in the nose.
Like, it almost looks like Pluto. That's what I'm going to name mine is Pluto, personally.
I can see that.
Yeah, because I'm getting both games. I don't know about you guys. I'm getting both games. So I only have to leave one starter out and then start a game over just to play through with the third.
Yeah, I already reserved both games already
as well. Yeah, same here. Got it with the Deoxys event.
All right, Gerard, what starter do you think you're going to pick up, and what are you excited about these starters?
Let's see. I think I would probably go with Litten, just because I do like my fire types.
Mm-hmm. Raven, what about you?
I'm pretty torn. I asked my wife which one I should start with, just because I'm buying both games, so I'm going to start one with what I want to start, and I'm going to start another one with what she picked. Me, personally, I think Popplio is pretty cool. I think I'm most likely going to pick that. I think I'm going to wait until my final decision until they release the final evolutions. But as of right now, I think Popplio is going to be my way to go. I thought Froakie was ugly and stupid looking, but it turned into Greninja and it turned out to be a boss. So I'm not going to...
Please tell me you weren't Team Fennec before that.
No, I was Team Chestnut. Okay. Yeah, Chespin. When I replayed X and Y, I actually chose Chespin as well. But yeah, so I think Popplio is going to be pretty cool. As far as typing, a lot of people are saying they're going to add fighting type typing to it.
That's what I thought as well.
I can kind of agree with that because of the description of what they have that Pokemon released for. Popplio basically talk about how it's like acrobatic and like moves around a lot, trains really hard and stuff like that. So fighting definitely makes sense to me. I was thinking psychic only because I was thinking about like a counter trio tree kind of thing.
See, I almost try to think of that as well, but it's so hard because like Litten obviously looks like a fire dark type for sure. So it's like, what does dark and flying have in common, you know? It's just like one of those things. Bug. We could have a water bug starter.
Dude, check this out. This is going to be the hidden ability for Rowlet, or whatever the bird, the owl is. Is it Rowlet?
Yeah, it's Rowlet. What hidden ability?
Okay. Thick fat.
You think it's going to be a fat bird?
It'll be thick fat as far as its hidden ability.
Personally, that'd be too strong though.
Think about it.
Like I said, I love all the starters this time around. But I gotta go with Rowlet. It's too adorable not to choose, in my opinion. I love it.
But yeah, if Rowlet did get that thick fat though, it would basically make it just times two weak to ice and neutral to fire, so that would be pretty. That would be pretty cool on that part. But
does flying resist itself?
No. Fire.
No, flying.
Flying.
Flying resists.
No, flying doesn't. So it would be times two weak to flying as well.
And then, what does it resist? Bug.
Yeah, flying resists.
Okay. Interesting.
So it would be neutral.
But with the grass, it would be neutral.
Yeah, I count it like super effectiveness, I got. Resistances, not a chance. There's too many resistances, damn it. Okay, but Raven, go ahead. You say that you have a whole list. Let's start going. Let's start knocking it out.
Oh, man. Okay, well, before they announced, this is just for me to put it out there. Before they announced the descriptions for each Pokemon, I noticed that the animation that they showed for Rowlet was different than any other grass move that existed. So that pretty much confirmed to me that there's new moves coming with this generation, which I think is super hype.
Serebii, I think, already have confirmed part of this. I think
it's called Leafage.
Leafage, yeah. Through at least your Japanese text, we could, you know, of course, get translations and stuff, making it something different. But yeah, Leafage is the name of the move.
Yeah.
Which I think is so cool.
Yeah. So
pretty rad.
So, but that definitely confirms, you know, new moves for this generation. So that's pretty hype. I feel like we've gotten in such a hole with Oris that it's like the same thing like over and over again. So just the little things like new moves being added and, you know, new tech and new abilities and stuff like that. I feel like it's going to be so rejuvenating to the Pokemon community. Super excited about that.
Raven, choose him on.
I know. I'm trying to think. He's times four, dude.
But he's like, burned, so he's only times two.
Still.
You're a Yon Mega. Protect once, you outspeed. What's a quick attack? You'll live.
I mean,
that.
I outspeed already.
Go Mega. Mega Yon Mega.
Dude, I wish he had a Mega, dude. That'd
Black
be
Dragon
so
awesome. Type confirmed.
Okay, so top of my list, one of the first things that I noticed about the video in itself, clothes customization. That is pretty much confirmed. I'm like 95% sure that's confirmed. I was watching the trailers and I watched it over and over and over again. And there's one scene where the main character is wearing a blue striped shirt. And in another scene, he's wearing a black striped shirt. And then in another scene, he's wearing a brown striped shirt. So for me, that pretty much confirms that we will be getting customization with this new gen, which is what the Pokemon community was really asking for.
Oris, it was understandable that they didn't choose to do it because, you know, it's a remake. It's supposed to be a remake, just, you know, updated graphics, etc., etc. And for them to not include that, even though they just did an X and Y, I felt like, well, wasn't upset, but at the same time, I can understand it because it was a remake game.
Yeah. Yeah, so that pretty much confirmed customization for me, which I'm super excited about. I mean, I just like being able to customize my character, like make it look like how I want it to look like.
I was dapper as fuck, if I have to say so myself, in X and Y. I was dapper as fuck. I spent so much money on clothes.
Yeah, dude. So, yeah. So, Gerard, what do you feel about customization? Are you pro-customization or anti? Because some people don't like customization. They think that you can fit more content into the game if you remove that aspect of the game, which some people want and they don't care about the customization. So how do you feel about it?
Well, I believe if they have customization, it would be more user-friendly for everyone. So, just because, you know, everything's like, I whatever, me whatever, so like having the benefit of customization is awesome in my opinion.
Yeah, man. So yeah, that's customization pretty much confirmed there. The next thing I have here, I noticed in the bedroom, one of the first scenes, you can notice like the globe that's there and like the Pikachu doll, and those items look super, super familiar to the forts that we used to have in Oris, and like when you built your own fort and stuff like that with the friend codes and stuff like that. So it's not confirmed, but I think that they might be bringing that back, which
like
I think is
something like customizable rooms.
Well, yeah, like, you know how in Oris you have your treehouse or your...
Oh, yeah, I know secret bases and stuff. But...
Yeah, the secret bases. So I think they might do something like that again, only because I remember in Oris, the way I leveled up my Pokemon, I found these codes for the bases. The Blissies, and
oh
I leveled
God.
Up my stuff so easily with that. So I think they're going to bring some type of secret bases back into this game, but
not
what do you guys think?
Okay, first of all, when it comes to the Blissey thing, I love it. I love that aspect just of anything, because I can take a level 1 to level 97 in one battle, and I love that. But other than that, like, when it comes to secret bases, I never have been one for it. Yeah, when I was younger, completely, I was totally for it. But as I got older, it's just like one of those things that I never really started to like understand, and that's why I kind of stayed away from competitions. You know, all the beauty competitions, cool competitions, all that stuff with Black and White. I'm sorry, Oris. But I don't know. I feel like because it's something different, new region at least, the Alola region, Hawaii confirmed completely as well.
Yes.
That it's just, I don't know. It'll probably be something completely different because everyone's like, oh, it's going to look like X and Y. It's going to look like X and Y. No, it doesn't, in my opinion. So as far as secret bases, if they bring it back, I'm not going to be mad. I'm not going to be mad at it. And I'll definitely give it a shot.
Yeah, dude.
All right, question. Hold up. Do you guys think they're going to have Ash Greninja?
Oh, definitely. There's got to be some variant of that. Because there's, at the same time, because we also got introduced to the Zygarde forms. You know, the 10%, 50%, 100%, all that stuff, the 1%. We got introduced to that stuff at the same time as Ash Greninja. Then they just left it at that. There is no way, especially because it's Koro, that it's just going to be left to the anime. I feel personally we'll somehow get some variant, or it won't be called Ash's Greninja. It'll just be called, like Elevated Greninja or some, you know, like I said, it's like some kind of mega. It's some sort of form of Mega Evolution, but to a different scale. And we're definitely going to get the Zygarde forms and Sun and Moon. We're definitely, and so because of that, I feel like we're definitely going to be seeing Ash's Greninja sometime in the future. Whether it's going to be event or special encounter, something like that. I don't know. There's just no reason not to, because it's so prevalent everywhere, you know? Yeah. There's no sense just to leave it to the anime.
I hope so. That's all I gotta say.
Because that's gonna be freaking Ubers as all hell.
I wonder how they're gonna do that. I was wondering if it was only gonna be exclusive to Greninja. And if so, that means, like, you're gonna get a Greninja in-game somehow.
Mm-hmm.
And, like,
yeah. I was actually starting to form like a theory for the podcast, but I'm pretty much at a wall right now because there's not enough information out there on the internet for me to piece stuff together. But I was basically analyzing the differences and the commonalities of the TCG, the video game, and the anime. At this point right now, it looks like they're going in different directions. Like, right now at the TCG level, the trading card game level, they're introducing this new form of evolution called Break Evolution.
Which is strange.
Which is basically the Pokemon is at its maximum potential and it turns like gold. So that's just weird in itself. Dude, you win. I don't know. Why am I still playing? Dude, your team just countered mine so bad. And I'm living too. So the TCG has that. The TCG also introduced in the new set that came out on May 2nd, the Zygardes. It released Zygarde 50% and Zygarde the ultimate, 100%. The 100%. So it introduced that into the TCG. And when you read the description of TCG and stuff like that, it looks like there's a backstory to it, kind of like Magic the Gathering has like its own backstory to it, like with the reasoning why those cards exist and what they do. So it looks like the Pokemon trading card game has something to that extent as well. Because I was reading the description, basically they were saying that there's two dimensions that were colliding, and that's what was creating these break evolutions. Yeah, so, like, basically these two dimensions are pretty much colliding, and it's messing stuff up in the Pokemon world. And that's why Zygarde is at 100% now, and it's just craziness. So, looking at that, looking at where the anime is going, the new movie's coming out with Magearna and stuff like that, and the Ash Greninja that kind of dabbles in, like, you know, Pokemon Fusion with the trainer and stuff like that, which I spoke about that in another podcast. And then the video game, like Sun and Moon, it's its own region. You know, I was looking at the map of Alola and trying to see like if I can see anything else, but they cover a lot of stuff up, and the region actually looks pretty small too. But I was trying to find a correlation basically between all these, you know, forms of Pokemon.
Holy
and I was
shit.
Trying to figure out if they're going to combine them in some way. Well, what'd you find?
Oh, we're just in the next battle, and my Aurorus lived you are plus one. No, a Swords Dance Drapion Aqua Tail, and I lived on 1%.
Yeah.
Rip me.
So yeah, I was trying to find a correlation and, you know, trying to see where the video game is going next, because to be honest, the video game is my main focal point. I do mess around with the TCG online once in a while just to see what's going on, and I like trading card games, but the video game is my main focus. So I was trying to see, you know, where's the video game going? Because you can see in the Japanese versions of Pokemon Sun and Moon, the title, there's like a new stone or gem in that title. So I don't know what they're going to introduce, something new, or I'm not completely sure. So I was trying to figure that out, but, you know, doing some research, it's come back inconclusive at this point. But something to keep in mind, that other forms of evolution and different forms of Pokemon do exist besides Mega Evolution. So that's something to keep in mind when Sun and Moon information continues to roll out, and it's a possibility, and Pokemon might go there.
That sounds good. I hope not, because then there'll be like three things, like a Mega. Oh my god. I don't know. Sorry. I was thinking like VGC 16 still. Like, you get a restricted and a Mega. Oh my god.
VGC 17 is going to be insane, probably.
I can't wait personally. Yeah.
I guarantee you, Mega Kanniscon won't be in it.
Oh, definitely. Please let it just be Sun and Moon.
Like, I don't think they're going to bring Kanniscon back into the new gen for the new VGC. Basically, I think they're going to leave it out. And basically, VGC 17 is going to be strictly just the Pokemon within Sun and Moon. So, what do you think? What do you think this new game is going to do to the VGC scene, since, you know, since you're going to Worlds and you're experienced in VGC? Like, what do you think this new game is going to do?
Well, potentially bring out more players, obviously, I think, because every time a new gen comes out, like, there's this huge spike in like people coming out to events and actually trying stuff out again.
You absolutely win this. I want you to know right now, I'm about to get swept.
Except Shrika. Shout out to Pokemon Black Nuzlocke.
All right, Edison, hello.
Alright, so that's basically my rant on TCG correlation and Pokemon game and stuff like that. Some other notes that I have here for the reveal, and these are pretty much obvious things, but just things that I've noticed. They redefined, like, they pretty much went more detail with the shapes of people. They're a lot more realistic.
They're
like,
not chibi.
They don't look, they don't look stuck, like, they don't have, like, stubby legs anymore. Like, you can see, like, a tall person, like, one of the guys standing by the yellow truck. He was, you know, a taller guy. He was slender. Like, you can definitely see definition in these, in different people's, different people's shapes. So, I think they're really investing. I think they kind of came to the point where the animation for the Pokemon battles and stuff like that, like, it looks good, and I think they'll tweak it up here and there for basically smoothness of the battles, especially with double battles with like Megas and stuff like that. It gets to go a little slow, so I think they're going to tweak that and fix that. But I think now with the regular gameplay and walking around, they're really making it into like a visual RPG game where you're not just looking at these stubby people walking around.
It
like
honestly almost reminded me of looking at XD Gale of Darkness the first time it came out. Like, yeah. That personally to me is how I felt about it. The long legs, the big chibi heads and stuff, and it was honestly beautiful. Like, the game in itself, the graphically wise, is just so well polished.
Mm-hmm.
And that to me, like, shows just how much, you know, one generation or one game can really do for a series. Like, seriously, like, I don't know. It's just, I'm speechless because it's just that.
I totally agree. I totally agree. Like, from Black 2, White 2 to XY was the biggest necessary jump ever.
Yeah.
Like, and for it to just be that Pokemon again.
Yeah, just to make it look even better. Oh my gosh, really, dude?
I want you to know this is legitimately the only decent thing I have.
I have a Bibero, and that's the best thing I have on my team. Oh my gosh.
Okay,
dude.
No, I'm not gonna lie. My team is pretty lit right now. I'm not gonna lie.
I can see it already. I don't even care.
I'm not gonna. Alright. Okay.
Let's see what I can do. I don't know. Let's try this. Alright, so another thing visual with the game, you can tell that they've changed the point of view slightly for the game. They've made it more horizontal, so you can see out into the street and the background a lot more than you can in X and Y. X and Y is a little bit more diagonal down, but this game it's like behind. It's like third person view behind.
Yeah.
And you can see a lot more of the scenery and stuff like that in this game.
As far as all Pokemon games have gone, you know, it's always been top down. You know, it's been a top down third person RPG. This just looks third person, and that to me is absolutely stunning in and of itself, because you see the camera moving as, god damn it.
Did this Bibarel just body Deoxys? This
just bodied Deoxys.
That's what usually happens.
Never underestimate the power of Bibarel.
That's...
But yeah, it just showed, like, seeing it in just as a third person alone with the camera being able to move, I'm wondering if in the new 3DS... the new 3DS console itself, the little mini joint stick will be able to move the camera. I just thought of that right now.
That is good. That's a really good idea.
Mm-hmm.
But then I don't want it to be a 3DS.
Pokemon,
new 3DS.
Game Freak, come hire me. I'll come up with great ideas like this all the time. I'll make you good money.
It will exclude and alienate players that still use an old 3DS, though.
Yeah, it would, unfortunately. Buy our new product today!
Yeah.
Alright, so...
Let's see. Okay, the big thing I think we're avoiding here is obviously the legendaries.
No, don't go there yet. That's my last thing.
Okay, we'll hold off.
That's my last thing.
We'll hold off.
And I don't have much left to go over anyway.
Okay.
Another thing I saw in the game that impressed me personally was... sorry, I'm losing my focus here. Oh my gosh.
I'm eating it.
Please harvest.
Yes. Oh, I hate you.
Yeah, I don't think I would live another...
You're not going to.
Yeah.
I refuse.
You're not gonna. I'm not gonna live another one. I'm sorry.
That was my role. You're good.
I noticed that in the trailer, they actually showed a as the main character was walking by, that guy that was standing by the truck, the yellow truck in the city. The guy was following, like, looking at the kid and following him, which is pretty creeper status, but it shows, like, there's AI reaction.
Mm-hmm.
Like, there's more reactions and just little things that they added. Like, AI has reaction. Like, you walk by them, they're going to look at you, which I think is super, super, super cool to have that added in there just to make it look more realistic. Because if you think about the older games, people just walk back and forth, and it's like, what are you doing? Like, you're just walking back and forth from one rock to another. Like, in this one, from what we've seen, the AI is a lot more responsive. They actually have a purpose of what they're doing. They're not just standing there walking around. So that's just like another plus for me in regards to making the game more realistic and visual.
Something I want to say is one of my personal... screw you saying you don't have anything. Freeze.
Shut up, dude. You know what?
No, yes, I do know what is up. What is up in the butt?
I hope I unfreeze right now.
You ain't gonna... Nope. I that's so weird that you can mega evolve and still be frozen. Stupidest thing ever. But one of the personal theories I have for the region itself is we got an overcast of the island that we started on, right? And Alola region, Aloha, almost sounds like, basically like we've said, it's honestly gonna be Hawaii, if not some other things and cultures mixed in. My theory is it's like, you know, as, is that we're not on the big island of Hawaii, we're on one of the smaller islands. And we gradually go to the bigger islands of the Aloha region, which is where, you know, the expansive, you know, more city-based tourist attractions like rainforest-filled islands are, and where we'll be able to go and travel and get to the gym leaders and stuff. At least that's what I believe.
That sounds really nice in the concept, because that means a bigger map visually, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I think they had to have only shown us one little portion, in my opinion.
Yeah,
it didn't look like
these are like based on like our original gameplay for Pokemon has been rather pitiful, like until X and Y with the Lumio City basically being really expansive.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and then let's not forget, of course, you know, another palette to the skin. Can we just like. Make that be a like I'm so happy that they did that personally, because I think just like with the three they had for X and Y was just almost kind of like a cop-out. It's like, yeah, we have light, somewhat dark, and somewhat light, somewhat dark, and somewhat Mexican.
Yeah,
and it's like that to me just they had white and somewhat dark. That's what it was. And, and for me it just kind of felt like a cop-out, and so I'm happy to see that, you know, Pokemon is actually noticing that they do have very, very, you know, ethnic players. That, as well as the fact that the potential professors that we do see, the younger guy and then the older guy. What, the younger guy's name was Kukui or something like that, and then the
Kukui,
and then the older guy's name was Hala. It's been confirmed that through Cerebi that the older guy's name is Holly or Hala or something like that, and both are named after trees, believe it or not. Fuck, dude, screw you and your crit.
Dude, you have milk drink, you're gonna stall the crap out of me.
I don't care, but screw you and your crit. I don't want to waste another turn. And so I just like the fact that, you know, we are getting to that point now where it's like we can really do some really cool things with some of these professors, for sure. And the fact that, you know, you're not in a lab, you're like in the middle of like a hut tribe thing, and it's almost like, almost looks like a ritual to me. It's like, here is your ritual to actually go ahead and choose your starter, you know?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That sounds really cool.
I'm sorry.
Yeah. I'm sorry. Dude, this smoke tank is gonna body me. I hate it.
But yeah, and then the rival, he looks really cool. I just feel like Pokemon's gonna play that gimmick where it's like, oh, he's like your friend, nice guy kind of rival, and he's not gonna be like a blue or a silver type of rival, which I kind of do miss. I like having that one antithesis to the main character. Yeah,
it made you wanna like actually beat your rival.
Exactly. Like, Wally was absolutely annoying. May played no relevance. Wally played no relevance. Black and white 2, not even close. And then, with everyone we had an X and Y, it was just irritating at that point. It's like, okay, enough with all the people.
Yeah, I really love that. It's Hawaii. Dude, your power... Oh my gosh, this mil tank.
This is why I hate... Like I said, I hate...
Oh, my team, for this reason. My team is trash. You have a milk tank. Really? Gen 2. That gym. Worst gym ever.
Watch my nipples. But yeah,
I also... off topic. This is TLTPG related, though. I challenged... in the day, and he totally wrecked me.
Who did?
I challenged Steven today for a gym battle.
Totally got shrecked.
Yeah, he totally wrecked me. I forgot about.
Oops. I did see your notification. I have to prepare for two other battles right now, so I'll probably get to you in about a couple days, Gerard. Hopefully.
Oh no! I still have to beat Steven, so...
I mean, you can go in any order. It's just once you lose 4, you gotta start all over.
I needed a crit there.
Okay, so... do we have anything else that we really need to talk about as far as the trailer, besides the obvious at the end?
Daytime and nighttime is confirmed.
Yes. Duh. Daytime, nighttime confirmed.
I literally wrote end of that.
Is there... let's see.
There is a topic I want to discuss.
Go ahead.
What moves would you like to see?
I would like something along the lines of what Pokemon Insurgents has done. Pokemon Insurgents, as you guys know, is, you know, the fan-made game that's near completion, has, you know, Delta Species Pokemon, which is really cool in and of itself. But one of the things that they did was with Delta Charizard, Mega Charizard, it had this like ability called like Necro Void or something like that, which was almost like the opposite of Sunny Day. And I feel with Sun and Moon coming out, I feel like it would be really cool in and of itself if they went ahead and they actually, you know, did like a nighttime Sunny Day thing, like Moon Glow or Moonshine. That up the power of fairy and dark type moves. Because personally, I think fairies go with the moon really well, because one of the strongest hitting special attacks is called Moonblast.
I don't know, dude. Powering up Pokemon like Sylveon, I don't know.
Sylveon
moved down to UU just now.
Really?
Let's see. Are you guys battling, or...?
I need a break, because that milk tank really made me salty.
Alright, Jerome, let's go again.
I'm gonna play on tilt if I play again, and I don't want to play on tilt.
Alright.
But I definitely want to see, this is gonna sound really weird, and random, but I want to see... moves of... okay, so different typings usually go with a different archetype of physical or special. Like, for example, mostly all fighting Pokemon are physical. You can run a special fighting Pokemon, but there's not enough moves to really make that super viable. So I want to see like some more special fighting moves or some special rock moves, because there are some Pokemon that you can run special and rock that are rock Pokemon and special, and it's not really viable because the moves that exist, like Ancient Power, that's basically the only special rock move that there is. So I want to see more variation of special and physical where it's not existent. I think fire has a good variation of special and physical. I think electric needs a better physical attack besides Thunder Punch and what's the other one?
Wild Charge.
Yeah, and the Wild Charge is only 90 damage, and you take recoil. Flare Blitz, it's 120. You take recoil. Like,
I thought
it's
Wild Charge was 120, wasn't it?
No, it's 90.
Really? Wow.
Yeah, it's exactly. So they either need to change Wild Charge to make it 120 and make it more viable, or make a better move. Like, I think Pokemon does it like that to basically have balancing, so there's not weirdly unbalanced moves in Pokemon and with different moves and stuff like that. But it's just something I want to see. I want to see types where if it's lacking in physical type attacks to add them or vice versa. That's just me.
I like that. I like that thought because, you know, at some point, shit, you outspeed me by one damn point, I bet. It's just like one of those things where it does get irritating after some time. It's like, oh, it's a fighting type, you know it's going to be physical. Oh, it's yeah. It's a water type, mostly it's going to be special. That's why I like the thought of our water starter being water fighting, because I feel like it could be the opposite kind of like of how Samurott was, because with Oshawa, it was bipedal, bipedal, then quadruped. Yeah. I feel it's going to be like quadruped, quadruped, bipedal at the end of the day.
Yeah, I mean... But if you look at the existing water fighting Pokemon, like Poliwrath, it's pretty trash. Like, it has a pretty trash moveset, to be honest. I mean, if you look at it...
Oh my god. Even,
it learns Focus Blast.
How many freezes have I gotten tonight? Like, three?
Yeah, you're the hex person today.
I am Miguel.
You've gotten too many hacks today. I think you need to take a nap.
I really do.
But, yeah, so, I mean, that's kind of what I want to see, like, special rock moves. So, if someone wanted to run a Lunatone or a Solrock, it hit on the special side, instead of just Ancient Power, they can do something else. Mm-hmm. That's just me.
Let's see. I'm trying to go through the trailer. I'm just trying to remember and see if there's, like, anything we could have possibly missed out, besides the obvious, of course.
Yeah, I don't know. I watched that trailer about 15 times today, so, and I took notes on everything that was basically, I mean, it's not like I covered everything that could be covered, but from what I was able to tell and confirm and talk about, that's basically all I've gotten, even though we've talked about this for a while and are avoiding the main thing right now.
Of course. And I feel like now's the time to really get into it. We are going over an hour right now, so.
Yeah, so let's get into this. Gerard. Sun or Moon, Gerard?
Oh, that's an easy one. My girlfriend she wants Moon, so I'm going Sun. however, did you guys see that freeze for like 7 turns?
Yes, yeah. I did.
Oh my goodness.
I done did that freeze, so.
So, Gerard, what do you think about the legendaries that were released?
Oh, I do, and I really would like to use that Moon legendary, because it looks really rad, in my opinion. But the lion looks cool, too.
That lion. I swear, I said this in chat, you guys. If y'all motherfuckers don't name him Mufasa or something majestic, swear to God, I'm gonna be pissed off at you.
I don't name my Pokemon through gameplay, the first playthroughs.
I always do.
No, I don't name them until like another playthrough. If I do like a Nuzlocke or a Wonder Trade Lock or something like that, I won't name my Pokemon, because that's how I learn Pokemon names. Mm-hmm. So you like the Moon legendary. I forget what... I don't have the names of the legendaries.
We don't have the names, technically.
The leak is not, like, the, 100% confirmed.
The copyright leaks aren't confirmed, unfortunately.
Yeah, so... So you like the Bat one better. Thumb Brother, what do you like more, the Lion or the Bat?
Dude, I don't know. For the longest time, I've been like... Because my favorite Greek god is Apollo. So, and, like, I have, like, such an affinity for the sun. It's like, yeah, you know, Team Sun all the way. That, while the Lion Sun Legendary, oh my god, dude. It was heaven. It was heaven on Earth just to see that zoom in on his face. The Moon Legendary looks... Dude, it looks bad as fuck, I'm not gonna lie, bro. I want to get up close and personal with it. I want to shake its hand. Let's do this. If you can see me in the do this thing. It's like I want to see. I want to shake that hand, and like seriously, I'm so glad I'm getting both, because I feel like the storylines, you know, are while usually similar, are gonna be extremely different.
Yeah. I'm hoping they're not like exact copies with slight differences. Like, I hope they're actually different. So are you? I'll give my answer in 1 second. But so you guys aren't mad of it? A lot of people are talking about how the bat is just like another Neuvern or another Zubat.
No, if anything, I don't think
the line is like a Pyroar, basically.
No.
You don't think that's a cop out of design or anything like that?
No. Not at all, because at the same time, you know, I'm pretty sure if we do our research, because Pokemon always does their research. They definitely do their research, because Xerneas and Yveltal and Zygarde are all based off of the Yggdrasil tree, which is in Norse mythology. I'm willing to bet they've done their homework here. Yeah. So I'm pretty sure somewhere down the line, in like Hawaiian mythology or like...
It's funny, I was actually trying to Google Hawaiian mythology today to see what the lion and the bat represent, but Google wasn't cooperating, and there's not enough material on Hawaiian mythology on Google search.
This is why I feel like it's while it is mainly Hawaii, they are bringing in more islands probably around, or like maybe migration of Hawaii to it. Like, I know there's a lot of Samoans, a lot of Tongans that, you know, that do live in Hawaii, because, you know, I'm not gonna like kind of look the same, not being racist or anything, but yeah, I'm willing to bet that somewhere there, or maybe something that we're just not seeing with Hawaiian mythology, that there is some sort of bat or lying mythology with it. And to me, you know, Pokemon wouldn't have done it this way
if it weren't for a reason.
Yeah. So, I just personally don't feel it's a cop-out. I feel like the colors they have on them, and the cosmic faces and the cosmic wingspan, I think is the coolest freaking thing ever. Fan art people that like to draw, recreate that shit on paper.
I think
I know the typing for it. For that moon one.
I was about to go into that as well.
Alright, so my favorite Disney movie is The Lion King. So, dude, The Lion is so awesome. I used to watch Big Cat Diaries on Animal Planet all the time.
Yo, that was my
Lion, dude, like, bats are cool. I like how bats function with echolocation and all that kind of stuff. Like, I love that. But lions are just so boss. Like, I'm super excited about the lion.
Dude, did you hear his roar?
Yeah, dude. Like, I'm buying both of them, and I'm going to own both of them and have both of them in one game and just do what I need to do. But the lion is so cool. I'm not going to lie. It's my favorite, so... alright, so let's talk about the typing. I've heard a couple of theories and rumors and stuff of people talking about the typings for these Pokemon and stuff like that. So I want to hear what you guys think about the typing. So Gerard, you're just about to jump into it, so you go ahead, take it away, dude.
Alright, so basically, it would be crazy, but this is my far-fetched idea. I noticed that there was like some metallic ring type-esque around the moon character, something, and it might be like a ghost steel type, as a legendary, to help counter like Xerneas, right? Because then steel like beats fairy, but then is also weak to Yveltal, so like there's like a triangle in that way. You know what I mean? If there's trying to be like some type of link still back to, you know, Kalos at all, you know what I mean? And then as far as the lion, I was thinking it'd be like fairy fire, because they would never, they don't have that yet, you know what I mean? And I think that would be a really, really dynamic combo to have together.
In regards to the bat, like what you thought about the bat and its typing, Do you think they would add, like, use the ability levitate just because it's a bat? If you think it's going to be the steel ghost thing, do you think they would use its ability to be levitate and, like, not waste it, but, like, kind of use it just to give it that flying capability?
Huh. Screw you and your crit.
I don't know. That sounds interesting, though. Yeah, actually, that is the most feasible idea, though, because, I mean, like, that's how they got around Cresselia, like, being the moon, the lunar Pokemon, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because levitates. So, yeah, that would be totally, totally feasible.
Cool.
And really awesome.
Yeah, cool. I was just wondering, because usually legendaries, like, for example, X and Y, Yveltal and Xerneas, they had, like, the fairy aura and then the dark aura. So, in most legendaries throughout the Pokemon games, they have, like, these counteracting abilities with them. So that's why I was wondering, like, if it's not a flying type and they put levitate, then what would an ability for the lion be that it, like, and it can't, I don't know if they would make a new one or, like, a special one, but if you're gonna put a levitate user on the bat, what would you think you would want to put on the lion one?
As far as ability, it would. If it's a legendary, though, I don't think they would make it, like, levitate. Actually, just to think about it,
yeah,
like it would be something more like board control, like, for instance, you know, Fairy Aura and Dark Aura, and then So as far as that. Maybe they might even not really care about a levitate and just give it godly stats, you know, like, really high difference. Or it doesn't even matter.
Yeah, dude. I think they're gonna, I don't know what they're gonna do about the stats for these Pokemon, but I'm pretty sure they're gonna be beast mode.
My theory for that is, with, of course, Gen 3, we had, you know, heavy rain and, you know, heavy drought, or basically, can't remember the name of them completely, but super drought, super rain.
Which primordial almost, season, desolate land.
Yeah, there we go, yeah. And with Groudon, you know, that's almost basically like having the power of the sun, you know, intense rays shine down, the sun rays shine down. Mm-hmm. And so it's like, you can't really copy that, because that's Groudon's thing. So, my thought is that they might have the same ability that's like an eclipse ability.
So, well, you know what?
So instead of like fairy aura, dark aura, it's like some sort of like eclipse power, or like, well, like solar eclipse or lunar eclipse. There you go. Two different abilities. Both do different things.
Yeah.
Like, for what? But that sounds cool. That does sound like a good idea.
I mean, that's just my thoughts, though. I mean, I'm just
spouting out
nonsense.
No, this is an amazing concept. I was just thinking, like, what do you think? Like, what you're saying, it would react like fairy and dark aura?
I think so, saying? Yeah. Like this kind of goes back to, like, that, the midnight sunny day that I was talking about earlier. I feel like it might be something similar to that, because with lunar eclipse, you know, that's a new moon. Solar eclipse, the moon is in front of the sun, so maybe it's kind of like a rain sun kind of mixed thing, but it also powers up maybe dark type moves, psychic type moves, you know, something of that variant.
What if it's like, do you think we're ready for a new Pokemon type?
I was gonna go there.
I don't think they would, honestly.
I was gonna take it there too. That's funny.
I feel, in my opinion, that while it would be cool to see, definitely would be cool to see, I feel that besides Fairy being completely immune to Dragon, I feel like it should be like the first quad resist single by itself. That's just me, but I feel just like the typings we have now are perfect. They're in the right spot, everything counteracts everything correctly, and there are mons that can do the jobs that some mons can't. I feel like it's balanced really well. And if they added another type, I feel it, like, if they get it right, you know, goodness to them, but if they get it wrong, and people know they get it wrong, they're gonna get shit on, and they're just gonna spend the next X amount of years trying to fix the typing chart.
Yeah,
I think, I guess what I'm trying to, where I'm going to digress is, what type pairings do you think they're gonna come out?
Oh, like, you know, oh, you mean with, just in Pokemon in general, yeah, like, or the legendaries?
Like dual typing, like, as far as,
well,
legendaries or just new Pokemon.
Well,
in general,
when it comes to the legendaries, the Lion legendary Raven, I sent you an invite, but challenge, by the way.
Oh, crap!
It's all good. It's all good, brother. But my theory, and this is a Pokemon that I've wanted for a very long time. I personally might think that, just looking at its face, if you go and really look at the Sun legendary's face, I personally see it as being a fire electric type. And with, oops, what's going on with Skype?
I don't know.
Oops, I done lost your picture.
Hey, luckily, yeah, I don't have.
Your video went away too.
Oh, did mine crash? Uh-oh. Is it me? It's me. Jesus Christ. Okay, I'm back. Now,
all right, cool.
Oh, no, I'm frozen. What the heck? Of course, you know, we're
near. You're not frozen on my end.
Yeah, but on the recording, I am. Great. I love doing this live. Live editing, you guys. I'm sorry.
Hey, it shows, like, how good you are on the spot.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. Window capture. Let's see. Where am I going? Yeah, we'll do this. Come
anyway,
on.
Anyway, we'll keep talking. So at least there's audio for the people that are.
Yeah, definitely. Like, I can continue talking, but I personally see the Sun starter being electric fire. And that's just me. Because that's just like a typing that you've never seen before, even though it is quad weak to ground. I feel like that's where that levitate ability can come in.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Rotom Heat, definitely.
Let's see. Yeah, guys, you're going to really see some messed up things going on. I'm so sorry.
It's all good. It's near the end of the stream, so it's basically trying to kick us off. But in regards to typing for both of them, I'm not going to go into my theory yet. Basically, I kind of agree with the Lion. A combination of fire electric or fire fairy, I think they would work well. I also threw psychic in there, only because like the third eye that comes out on his forehead, I don't know, it looked kind of psychic-y to me, so I was like, hey, let's throw psychic in that possibility.
I was about to say, for the bat, personally, myself, like Jordan was saying, you know, I noticed, you know, the metal wings. I see it as a potential either ghost steel, like he said, or I see it as just a regular flying steel type, which is pretty interesting if you ask me, or maybe it's another steel dragon pot, potentially? I mean, maybe there could be a dragon type.
So rare. There's only one steel dragon in the game,
which is Dialga. But it's like, you know, scoot over, share the love. You can't be the only one.
Yeah. I think the bat. I'm around the same area, flying with dark, flying with ghost, flying psychic. But it's not very likely. I didn't think it was very likely for psychic to be it. But one thing I did notice while watching the video. The trailer was on the face of the Lion, you can see kind of like these stars kind of moving around and stuff like that on the Lion. But if you look at the bat wings as well, it also has like that starry kind of look in its wings. So I heard some people talking about a new type being added, and what that type would be a cosmic type, basically like an alien type, basically. So I was thinking about, like, you know,
it would be like dragon type, where like they're effective towards each other.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. I was thinking it would probably be something like that. It would be effective against, I don't know how the typing tables would work. And I don't know enough about, you know, the balancing mechanism and stuff like that, how Pokemon figures that out. But I was thinking basically anything, any Pokemon that has anything to do with being an alien or from outer space or anything like that would be this cosmic typing. Like, for example, Clefairy, I think it would be Fairy Cosmic. Or Lunatune and Solrock get an added type of cosmic on there. Deoxys would get an added psychic cosmic or something like that. So I did notice that they had that starry look on them, on the face and on the bat. So that was the only...
Is your webcam on, Raven?
What? It should be.
Yeah, I'm only seeing just your picture.
What? Alright, hold on. Let's see.
Yeah, because I noticed that both of ours scratched at the same time somehow. There we go. Okay, let me re-add you onto the layout.
Cool.
But yeah, another thing I thought of with the bat is, like, you know, of course, you know, it's a, you know, moon legend. It could potentially even be, like, a dark steel.
Mm-hmm.
And for that, you know, I wouldn't be mad. I wouldn't be mad at that.
Nope. I mean, we already have it with Bisharp, but still. This one would be a special... It looks like it's a special attacking Pokemon versus Bisharp's physical, so it would still be really cool.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, anime, Bisharp and Snarl really well.
Oh, yeah.
And at the end of the day, you know, like, I'm just so happy to have something to keep us entertained. Or at least tickling our fancies, as it were, until everything comes out November 18th.
All right, everyone say one new mega they want to see. Just one.
One new mega?
Brennan, you go first, because you might say what I want.
Personally, I want Mega Arcanine.
That's what I want too.
Literally, that's my favorite Gen 1 Pokemon.
Like, seriously. So...
That's awesome.
So Mega Arcanine, I feel like it's just waiting to happen. It's really waiting to happen. And with that, you know, it's just... God, this thing actually kind of wrecks my team. But at the same time, something besides what we all want with Mega Arcanine, I want a Mega... I feel like a Mega... Oh, what is it called? Don't tell me. You guys don't know, but don't tell me.
Oh, yeah. It should be that one.
Yeah. I think that one sounds cool.
I want something that'll change the metagame. Something that's unseen. Like Mega Butterfree. Something like a bug type. Mega Butterfree. Mega Young Mega. Maybe like Mega Mothim or something. Or even like... Megaladian. There we go. That's something. Megaladian. Or even go into normal types. Megatauros sounds powerful, if you ask me.
What would you change it to look like?
I mean, it would almost look like a Bouffalant. Or just like those cows that you see on roids.
So, at this point, you already know it's going to be other starters that that didn't Mega Evolve yet. That are gonna Mega Evolve.
If they show Mega Torterra tomorrow, I'm literally gonna flip.
You know it's gonna happen. They're gonna add another 15 Megas.
I feel that like if they kept it at like 10 max, they'll be good.
They're gonna add 15.
You feel like it'll be 15?
Like, well, at least in the teens, not just 10. Like, they added, like, what, I don't know how many they added for X and Y, but then Auras, they added, like, at least in the teens, if I recall correctly. Well, I can check that real fast.
I mean...
Let me check my facts.
What else could potentially Mega that we really do want to see?
I want to see second-gen Megas.
Mm-hmm.
Mega Typhlosion obviously would be too amazing.
Mega Typhlosion is exactly what... Typhlosion is my favorite starter, so that's exactly what I want to see, like, to the T.
If I may add a potential type to him, I say that a fire poison type is something that we are all in need for as well.
No, I think if he megas, he stays fire, right? But they give him a huge buff in speed so that like that it can just sweep in the sun, like, kind of thing, next to a Charizard, or not a Charizard, but I don't know, just something where it could just totally wreck based on speed alone, just like what happened to Mega Salamence.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, I mean, just like everything, oh, thank you, Crits, but seriously, just like everything that this that has been shown today has honestly changed so much and just changed the community in just a matter of minutes. It was a 2-minute video, you guys, and it completely changed everything. It literally changed everything. And
just, you guys, like, see the Japanese version?
I did. That's where a lot of people didn't realize that there was a lot more information shared than the American one, or like the English translation one, I can at least say. Because that's where we know about the fourth palette skin, or the skin palette, and the what's it called? What was it? The mom, I think, or like the extra lady. I seen the Meowth in the background. What else was there? I think the name of the move, actually, Leafage, that Rowlet has. I think that's where it was mainly translated from.
Yeah, so I'm super excited to see more stuff.
It's gonna be an interesting 6 months, you guys. I counted this out the second that I saw November 18th, like June, July, August, September, October, November. It's 6 months away, you guys. We have half a year until this game comes out.
Hey, for the Mega Evolutions, I know what we were talking about. I think it was I don't know if I counted incorrectly, but 20 they added in Oras. So it's easily at least 15 megas we're going to be expecting, if not another 20 the first time around. Let's see how many that we added. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. Yeah, like upwards in the 25-ish area.
Wow.
First time around. So yeah, we're expecting at least another good haul for the next game.
I personally can't wait. I feel like it's gonna be just so beautiful just to have. Like every single month or every other week, if something's released, you know, I'll be happy. Like, seriously, they're doing it right this time around. Because the fact that this video did not get leaked is phenomenal. I mean, the fact that someone didn't spill their beans about this.
I didn't mean to click that.
Yeah, on a side note, though, did anyone else think that Charizard X, after watching Pokemon Origins, was going to be, like, the most amazing, like, Mega Evolution?
Of course, because it was Pokemon Origins.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but, like, it was so disappointing when you got it in-game.
I feel, that's in a VGC format. In a singles counter draft team format, Charizard X is up there to potentially sweep. Like, I can't remember who it was that in our TLTPG draft league had Charizard X for their Mega, but legitimately, that motherfucker almost swept me. And I got extremely lucky who was it that came in and took care of business? I think it was a Scizor, of all things, came in and took care of business.
That's good.
But yeah, I mean, I don't think that there's much more that we can honestly say. Just, it's hype. It's hype central right now. Everyone's going to be having theories thrown out. It's going to be cool to come back every other week, or every week, hopefully, if we can. I mean, if our schedules allow it to come back and just continuously talk about this, because we definitely have months of material to talk about. And with every guest asking the same questions over and over, we can definitely go ahead and, you know, really hopefully get in some in-depth, what's it called, theories that we can each develop. And it's just going to be fun.
Yeah, dude.
Definitely.
But with that, I think we are good to go ahead and wrap up this week's episode. What do you guys think?
Yeah.
You want to wait till the end of this battle?
No. I mean, like, we can definitely continue. I know Gerard's gonna. I mean, yeah. I know you're gonna win, Raven. Absolutely gonna win. There's really no way I'm gonna win this. There's no way I can turn this around. Your whole team wrecks me.
It's better than.
Have you got team ideas yet, Brennan, for the regional?
Oh, no, unfortunately not. Yeah, because, yeah, Gerard, like, I live in Utah, you guys, and so earlier when Gerard was talking about coming up to Salt Lake Nationals, Utah Nationals, or Regionals, I'm sorry, Regionals, it's like, oh shit, I get to see this guy again. But no, I should start thinking about that tomorrow. Maybe watch some VGC players, see what's current meta, look at past PCs, and really start to build a team. Like, I feel like I can definitely do that in the next little bit.
When's your regional?
It is 28th.
Oh, 29th is on a Sunday. It was when it actually is. Oh, but yeah, the regional starts 28th. Like, for TCG, the whole actual event.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I remember last year, this time when Kapuno and his girlfriend Janae came up, man. That was some lit shit, because we were up all night trying to build me a team because I hadn't really prepared.
Nice.
And I legitimately went with a semi-big five at that time. I think I had Cress, Thunderous, Kangaskhan, Clefable, Ferrothorn, and I think one other mon. I can't remember. I think it was Scrafty.
Nice.
But yeah, I'm about to get wrecked. Maybe not. But yeah, I mean, there's really nothing I can do. Your Greninja comes in and cleans house.
I'm gonna try.
But yeah, like, I honestly can't wait. You know, it's gonna be amazing just to see what's going on. But with that, you guys, we're gonna go ahead and wrap up this week's episode. If you guys enjoyed this episode, please leave a like and a thumbs up down below, as well as a comment letting us know here at TLTPG what starter are you going to choose for Sun and Moon. Are you Team Sun? Are you Team Moon? What are your theories going on in your head? Please let us know. We will definitely read them. We will definitely talk about them. If you do comment, that'd be so nice. In the description below, we will also be leaving links to Gerard's Twitter. Because, like I said, like we've said, you guys, he is qualified for day one of World. So he is no joke when it comes to the VGC, side of Pokemon, which is absolutely phenomenal. Once again, Gerard, you know, now that we're on Skype, and, you know, I just really like to say, you know, congrats, man, because that shit is phenomenal. Like, absolutely, congrats to you, man. You really do deserve that.
You deserve that. Good luck on. Hopefully we can get you back on after Worlds, if not before that, but get you back on and talk about how it went, and hopefully you come back as a champion and bring the championship to TLTPG, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's exactly the plan. yes. Ash Greninja.
Mm-hmm. All right.
That's what I want to say.
But let's go ahead and plug ourselves. Gerard, go ahead and say your goodbye to everyone. Let everyone know your Twitter.
Oh yeah, you can follow me at GerardDC. That's my Twitter account. And then I'll actually go ahead and check out my band page, PUCKXOU Puck Zoo.
That go ahead is definitely going to be in the description, because that's been playing in the background this whole entire episode.
Cool. Thanks, guys. Yeah, I would appreciate that, TLTPG. And, you know, hopefully if you are a new friend for us, please, invite more friends so that we could you know, keep growing this whole little community we got going on.
Yeah.
It's good fun. It's good fun, and it's good. Did I mention it's good fun? Yeah, no, it's really nice.
Mm-hmm.
Really nice people to be here.
Raven, go ahead and plug your stuff.
All right. Well, Raven89, you can catch me on YouTube. I haven't done anything on my YouTube channel, but hopefully I can get some VGC content on there and stuff like that. So check me out on YouTube, just Raven89. You can also catch me on Twitter, Raven89 as well. And that link is also on my channel as well. And hopefully I can upload this podcast onto my channel and share it with everyone that's not part of TPG, so we can try to get some more members up in here and just grow our community. So,
oh, shit. Yeah, I totally forgot to send you that shit. I'm so sorry.
Dude, it's all right. Don't worry about it. We'll get this one. This one's, like, big.
This one's big, so we'll upload it. And, of course, I am Thumb Brother to you guys. I run, I do a couple series on this channel. I've finished the Pokemon Black Randomizer Nuzlocke. I'm starting the Pokemon Black 2 Randomizer Nuzlocke. Please make sure to check those out. And, you know, make sure, you know, just give those videos a thumbs up, because every little thumbs up means so much to me and everyone here at TLTPG. I also have my own YouTube page where I'm doing a Pokemon Storm Silver Nuzlocke. I'm sorry, Pokemon Storm Silver Nuzlocke. I think I said that correctly the first time. Who cares? But that's at Thumb Brother 2. My Twitter name is Thumb Brother 2 as well. And you know what? We're gonna get up out of here. This video's been going for an hour and 40 minutes. I am extremely tired. I'm sure you guys are. So we're gonna get up out of here.
It is 2:30 in the morning here. Peace out. I'm going to bed.
Peace.